Cinderella Castle is not only the icon for the Magic Kingdom, but a symbol of Walt Disney World itself. It is one of the most recognized buildings in the world, and is also one of the most photographed as well, with estimates of more than 30,000 photos per day, 365 days a year, being taken of the castle. The castle is more than just a focal point of the Magic Kingdom, more than a building or engineering feat. It actually has a deeper, almost spiritual meaning to many people, whose faces light up at its sight as they enter Main Street USA. The genesis of Cinderella Castle starts not in Florida, but in Disneyland. When Walt Disney was designing Disneyland, his new theme park in Anaheim, California, he wanted each of his themed lands to have an obvious landmark. He called these icons weenies. These weenies would act as visual magnets, which would lead guests from one land to another and act as a reward for making the trip. The castle that would stand in the center of the Magic Kingdom would be the largest of all the weenies, drawing guests further down Main Street into the park and being visible from every land therein. Once guests reached the central hub in Walt Disney World, weenies such as Space Mountain to the right or Big Thunder Mountain to the left would attract them to Tomorrowland or Frontierland. The use of weenies continued when Walt Disney World was being developed and was carried forward as new parks or lands were created. Epcot has Spaceship Earth as its main weenie, just as Disney's Hollywood Studios has the Sorcerer Mickey hat and Disney's Animal Kingdom has the Tree of Life. Cinderella Castle was inspired by a number of architectural styles as well as numerous castles throughout Europe, including the French castles and chateaux of Fontainebleau, Versailles, Chenonceau, Chambord, Chaumont, and Ussay. In fact, French writer Charles Perrault, the author of the original Sleeping Beauty and Cinderella, was said to have been inspired by Ussay, the Chateau of Dreams, for his fables. Castle designer Herbert Ryman also borrowed a large number of design elements from King Ludwig II's Neuschwanstein, or New Swanstone, castle in Germany, as well as the castle in the 1950 Disney film Cinderella. Like Neuschwanstein, which was built by connecting separate buildings to make one large traditional medieval castle, Cinderella Castle fuses several elements as well. While the castle base resembles a 13th century medieval fortress, it looks more like a Renaissance palace as it gets higher, becoming lighter and more delicate. This composite design reflects the evolution in castle design in Europe throughout the Middle Ages, including the Gothic architectural designs of 12th and 13th century France. The doorway to Fantasyland, Cinderella Castle rises up as the tallest structure in the Magic Kingdom at 189 feet and is more than 100 feet taller than Sleeping Beauty's castle in Disneyland. Unlike Disneyland's castle, Cinderella Castle was actually elevated during construction because Walt Disney had noted that he didn't think the castle was prominent enough in Disneyland. In fact, Cinderella Castle was designed so that it was tall enough to be seen from the Seven Seas Lagoon in front of the Magic Kingdom, where many guests take ferries or monorails from the parking lot to the gates of the park. Major elements of the castle were scaled and angled to give the illusion of both distance and height. Known as forced perspective, this filmmaking method is used frequently in Disney theme parks around the world. For example, using this method, the top spire of the castle is only half the size that it actually appears. The result is a castle that looks as though it's 300 feet tall. One of the most often asked questions in the park is how many stones make up Cinderella Castle. Well, as you probably can guess, the number is zero. That's right, no bricks were used in the castle's construction. Instead, it's made of concrete, steel, cement, plaster, and fiberglass in order to withstand the hurricane force winds of central Florida. The inner structure is made up of 600 tons of steel, covered with a fiberglass facade, while the concrete foundation is filled with foam for weight conservation. The interior and exterior walls were sculpted to resemble granite rock. Construction of the castle began in late 1969, took almost 2 years to complete, and was finished in July 1971. There are a total of 18 spires atop Cinderella Castle, which were fabricated and finished on property, hoisted by crane above the castle, where they were slid into place and attached. The tallest spire on Cinderella Castle is appropriately gold in color and is topped with a flag, assuring its place as the tallest structure in the Magic Kingdom. One of the flagpoles has an artificial flag that's actually a transmitting antenna for coordinating the Main Street parades. For many years, the long-standing rumor that there was a guest room available inside the castle was not true. But that all changed in 2006. Space for an apartment for the Disney family was originally planned for the castle's upper floors. However, when Walt passed away before the Magic Kingdom was complete, the apartment project was abandoned and never finished. Over the years, it had been used for storage, a telephone switchboard, and cast member dressing rooms. Inside, one of the multiple working elevators in the castle goes to that apartment. But do you want to see what the apartment is from the outside? Look for three tall windows with pointed arches near the top of the castle, facing out towards the center of Fantasyland. In 2006, this space was converted into a suite fit for a princess. The 650-square-foot castle suite contains a parlor, salon, bedroom, and bathroom unlike anything else in a Disney park, with 17th-century design combined with 21st-century amenities. Available only to guests who were randomly selected as part of Disney's Year of a Million Dreams celebration in 2007 and 2008, the prize also included dinner at Cinderella's royal table and other regal surprises. One of the additions to the castle over the years has been the castle four-court stage. While the area in front of the castle has been home to countless parades and shows, the stage has held presentations including Cinderellabration and the Dream Along with Mickey musical character shows. Surrounding the castle, there are approximately 3.37 million gallons of water in the moat. And although the graceful Plaza Swan boats once plied these waterways, the castle drawbridge cannot be raised. On July 4, 1985, Tinkerbell took her first nightly flight from the castle towards Tomorrowland and has done so every night, weather permitting, to kick off the evening's fireworks display. She flies about 750 feet at about 15 miles per hour on a trip that takes her about 34 seconds. Wandering up one of the dual pathways to the castle drawbridge, above the breezeway you can find the Disney family coat of arms created in stone. You can also spot it on the Fantasyland side of the archway and inside Cinderella's Royal Table restaurant on the second floor. There, it's displayed over a fireplace and consists of three red lions on a field of white. Above the portcullis is a working clock. Glancing at it, you'll notice that the number 4 is represented in four capital letter I's. Although today, we may consider the use of those four I's as incorrect, the use of these numerals on the clock was actually used in early times, including colonial America. The same numbering convention can be seen on the clock at the American Adventure Pavilion in Epcot, among other places, such as the clocks on Main Street USA's train station. Also, notice the hands of the clock, which feature a sun and a moon, and the 12 symbols of the zodiac. Looking elsewhere around the outside of the castle, see if you can find the 13 intricately carved winged gargoyles accenting the architecture. Inside the castle's breezeway, a series of 5 incredible mosaic murals tell the story of Cinderella. Designed by the late Imagineer Dorothea Redmond and crafted and set in place by a team of 6 artists led by mosaicist Hans Joachim Scharf, the 15-by-10-foot ornate panels are shaped in a Gothic arch. The murals took more than 2 years to complete and contain hundreds of thousands of pieces of smooth Italian glass and rough smalti. Smalti are pieces of glass made specifically for mosaics traditionally used by Italian craftsmen. In the breezeway, pieces of this glass can be seen in over 500 colors. Many of the hand-cut tiles are fused with sterling silver and 14-karat gold, and some are as small as the head of a tack. If you look closely, and you should, at these ornate murals, you'll notice that each of Cinderella's wicked stepsisters appears with a little added color. One sister's face is clearly red with anger, while the other sister is a little green with envy as they watch Cinderella try on the glass slipper. Also notice how the columns situated in the breezeway are decorated with mice such as Gus and Jacques, as well as birds from the Disney animated feature film Cinderella. These characters were sculpted by Blaine Gibson, who also created the partner statue located in the central hub. Inside the breezeway, between two of the mosaics, sits a doorway to the Bibbidi Bobbidi Boutique, a beauty salon where little girls are magically transformed into little princesses. Prior to the boutique opening in 2007, this space was home to the King's Gallery, one of the many unique shops in the Magic Kingdom, where guests could find a variety of Spanish-made swords, handmade dolls and clocks, German steins, carved chess sets, Russian music boxes, and so much more. Artisans inside the shop also demonstrated the practice of damascene, a 6th-century metalworking craft mastered by very few in the modern world. Cinderella's Royal Table Restaurant is located on the second floor of Cinderella Castle. Guests can take the circular stairway or elevator to this royal dining hall, where the younger guests can be treated like a prince or princess, and the older ones as a lord or lady. Oddly enough, this restaurant was formerly known as King Stefan's Banquet Hall, named after King Stefan, who was not Cinderella's, but Sleeping Beauty's father in the fairy tale and film, in an effort to give it an air of royalty. If you look around the elegant dining hall, with its stained glass windows and medieval decor, you will notice more than 40 coats of arms on display. Each of these is an actual family seal and represents some of the many people that played a major role in the design and construction of Walt Disney World, including Roger Brogy Sr., Mark Davis, John Hench, Dick Nunes, and Marty Sklar. Since October 1st, 1971, Cinderella Castle has gone through a number of changes, both large and small. To commemorate Walt Disney World's 25th anniversary in 1996, Disney magically transformed Cinderella Castle into an 18-story birthday cake. Complete with red and pink icing, giant pieces of candy, and 26 glowing candles, the most photographed building in the world served as the centerpiece for the 15-month-long celebration. In October 1998, Cinderella Castle's beauty was accented even further with the installation of a new lighting system, which illuminated the palace in 16 million colors and more than 60 color changes synchronized to the evening's fireworks. On May 5, 2005, in honor of Disneyland's 50th anniversary, the castle's exterior was adorned with polished gold trim and accents, banners, bunting, and tapestries, while golden statues of Disney animated characters were added to the structure. Just above the front archway sat an enormous stained glass mirror modeled after the magic mirror in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, which changed images every 40 seconds to feature each Disney castle from around the world and the date its park opened. The decorations were removed in late September 2006, after which the castle was repainted from top to bottom with a slightly different color pattern, including adding rose-colored hues to the taller sections. Walking through the breezeway and looking to your right, you encounter a somewhat hidden pathway, along which you will find another of Cinderella's hidden treasures. Halfway down on your right, nestled among picturesque trees and flowers, is Cinderella's very own wishing well. For years, children, parents, and lovebirds have thrown their change into the fountain, hoping to make dreams of their own come true. But as with other fountains around Walt Disney World, the change collected from here makes real dreams come true, as Disney donates the money to various local charities. Along this quiet footpath to Tomorrowland lie boulders and trees evocative of a French countryside, which is appropriate, as the quaint Bell's Fairy Tale Garden Theater sits at the bottom of the walkway to your left. Created in 1999, it's currently home to the Storytime with Belle show. With a stage that is raised up just a few feet off the ground for little theatergoers to see, it sits in front of four rows of stone benches. The 15-minute show that plays multiple times daily welcomes a number of lucky young volunteers into the show and affords unique photo opportunities with the characters and performers afterwards. Heading back up to the top of the pathway, you can see that you have stepped inside the castle's fortress as the landscape of Fantasyland is revealed. Elements of the design of the castle, including the colors and spires, can be found throughout Fantasyland, as we'll see along the way. Keep your eyes out for castle walls and turrets, as well as an extension of the castle itself as you explore Fantasyland. Along the way, we will see how this medieval village evokes images from various periods and locations throughout Europe, yet retains a consistent theme of a festival-like atmosphere within its storybook surroundings.